Hey Sagittarius, thanks for visiting the Zoo Weekly Reading for April the 2nd to April the 8th. And as always, if you like this reading, please like or subscribe or leave a comment. And I'm just going to start right now with your reading for Sagittarius, and I hope you're okay. The first card you have, your past, is the Seven of Wands. Right, so yes, there's a battle. Obviously, this is a card of battles. I'm seeing a battle. Excuse me. Sorry, I keep coughing all the way through these readings. You know, I don't feel like coughing, and then when I go to do a reading, I suddenly feel like coughing. It's ridiculous. Sorry about that. Yes, there's a battle. This is a card of battles, and I'm seeing struggling here, but I'm seeing you struggling against... I'm not seeing you struggling against a person or people. I'm not seeing you having a struggle or a fight or a disagreement with any people. I'm seeing that this is probably against a system or something like that. And I'm seeing this banging your head against a brick wall, that kind of saying like that. It's like you're not literally, I'm not seeing you literally banging your head against a brick wall, but it's like that's how you feel because you're so frustrated, or you were at this time very, very frustrated, trying to get through something, trying to do something. I'm seeing technology, so you could have been trying to do something online and it kept on saying no or stopping, or the connection failed, or maybe you asked for your password and you couldn't find it. All this kind of crazy stuff that drives you crazy. And then I'm seeing that you probably were on the phone as well trying to do something or organize something. It might have been paying bills or something, and it might have been, you know, it's like, you know, sometimes you go to pay a bill and you're right on the day, you're trying to pay it, and then it stalls or the connection goes out, and then like, oh, now I'm going to be late, and oh, and so all of this kind of stress happening. That's what I'm seeing. I'm seeing you trying to sort out something practical. Yes, I'm really feeling this frustration when I see this card. And yes, it's against a system, not people. It's not like you're against people, because I'm seeing this, if you look at this card, they're the ones underneath this person that are fighting this man. You can't see anyone's face. They're just wands sticking up and poking him. Like, you know, there are people there, but it's like a faceless system. That's what I'm seeing, this faceless system. You're battling against this faceless kind of system. Yeah, I keep saying it again, faceless system. I've said it about 50 times. Yeah, so this is fighting against, yeah, you can't see these people. You can't see whoever this is. It's just like this, you know, when you go to ask, you're on a website and you're just frustrated and you're struggling and you're trying to get through something and you're trying to ask a specific question, but then it has, oh, frequently asked questions, and of course your question's not there, and then you go to email and there's no email on there, and you go to phone them, there's no phone number on. It's that kind of frustrating stuff. Meanwhile, time's ticking away and you're trying to do something. That's what I'm seeing. So frustrating. You might have even been on hold to someone and trying to take care of something, or caught up in red tape or something like that. Something very frustrating. This is the retrograde. I'm going through this as well. A lot of people are going through this frustrating time. Yes, it will pass. It will pass. The next card you have, your past, is the Nine of Pentacles. So for single people, if you're looking for a relationship, yes, I'm seeing, look at this beautiful, beautiful woman, this beautiful person. So there's someone there, you're very attracted to this person, or you were at this time, you probably still are. And yes, you're interested in this person, you were interested. I'm seeing that you're a little bit afraid to approach them. You're a little bit afraid of them, not afraid of them, it's not like they're scary or anything, but they could be giving you some kind of impression that they're so independent that they don't want or need anyone or something like that. Because look how content this woman is. She's in her garden, she has everything she needs, she's not looking at you, she's looking at the bird and she's just having a fun time, and you know, she's content by herself. She doesn't need any people around her. She's fine by herself. And this might be a little bit intimidating to you. She's very, very independent, or this person, whoever this is very independent. And yes, this person can even seem a little bit distant from you. And yes, they're an emotionally stable person. I'm seeing that as well. I'm not seeing any reason why you should be worried or afraid of this person. They do have, they're quite a well-off person, not just financially, but inside themselves. They're very stable emotionally, because stability, the Pentacles are all about stability, and this person feels very stable, very calm. And yeah, they have a quiet strength around them. But don't be afraid of this person. Don't worry about this person. Don't worry about approaching them. They're very approachable. They're very approachable. That's what I'm seeing. The last card you have for your past is the King of Swords. So yes, I'm still seeing, yes, the same things, practical problems, just like in the Seven of Wands, practical problems. You're just dealing with, you're trying to, you're very frustrated, that's what I'm seeing, but you're trying to get your emotions out of this, because when things build up and up and up like this, I don't know about you, but with me, they build up, and then I'm so emotional, I'm just about to scream at the person or cry at the person, and I have to really take some time out before I call someone, because I'm about to just go crazy at them. And I don't know if you're like that. You're probably not like me. You're probably a lot more sensible than I am. But yes, you had to try and calm your emotions. So I'm seeing you probably had to speak to someone on the phone or something like that. And I'm seeing you have to really, you had to remove your emotions. You had to try and just speak to them properly, because it's not their fault, a poor person on the phone. It's not their fault. So you had to try and just be calm and repeat the problem again and again. So you could have been speaking to more than one person. You might have been speaking to one person, explaining the whole thing, and then they say, oh, I'll put you through to blah blah someone else. You go to someone else, and then you have to explain yourself to them. So it's so frustrating, but you were very, very you're very kind of diplomatic about this. You're very civil, you're very civilized with these people. You weren't letting your emotions get in the way of what you wanted to do. And I'm also seeing determination. You kept going until you did this thing, whatever this was. That's what I'm seeing. So the first card you have here present is Judgment. Right. This is what I'm seeing here in this Judgment card. You are trying to avoid someone in this card. That's what I'm seeing. Yes, it might not resonate. That's what I'm seeing. You might be trying to avoid someone. This could be an ex. This could be a person who's all over the place emotionally. I think I've seen this person in your last readings. And I'm seeing someone trying to come in and out of your life. They're trying to come in, they're trying to come out, and they're trying to use all sorts of different kind of tricks to come in and out. And if they're not satisfied with your attention, they want your attention. If they're not satisfied with the attention that you give them, then they try and do all sorts of tricks to get your attention. It's like they're trying to kind of accuse you of things, judge you of things, get other people to come and judge you. But actually, you're judging them as well. You're judging their behavior as well. So you're both judging each other. I'm not seeing who's right or wrong, but clearly they're wrong if they're making up things about you. That's clearly wrong. Or they're just being silly to get your attention. That's clearly, you know, ridiculous behavior. I am seeing, yes, someone's trying to accuse you of things, or they're trying to spread stories around about you or something like that. And yes, they try to get your attention. It's ridiculous. It's like they're trying to get you to like them or to see them again or talk to them again. But then they try and spread these things about you. So how do they expect you to speak to them again or want to speak to them if they're spreading stories about you? I wouldn't want to speak to someone like that. It makes no sense. But yes, this person's very, if this is the person I keep on seeing, your ex or whoever this is that I keep on seeing in your readings, this person is really up and down emotionally, all over the place. And yes, you're trying to avoid them. That's what I'm seeing. And I don't blame you. I would do the same as well. You just want to escape this drama. I can see that. Totally see. That's what you were doing. And that's what I do as well. That's what I'm seeing. So yes, the next card you have here present is the Eight of Pentacles. The Eight of Pentacles. Look how hard this guy's working in the Eight of Pentacles. He's not looking up or anything. And he's got raggedy clothes on. He doesn't care what he looks like. He's just work, work, work. And this is what I'm seeing. You're still working really hard. And I see this a lot in your readings, that you just work and work and work. You're trying to build your way up to something that you had or to a position that you're in. And I'm seeing this a lot, that you're in a better position, and you actually could have been like this a few times. You could have been in a good position financially, in a comfortable position, and then things went wrong and they went down again, and then you built it up again, and I'm seeing that they're okay again, and then they went down again, and now you're building your way up again. So I'm seeing that happening up and down in your life, this financial up and down. And I'm also seeing it could have even happened in your childhood. You could have this in your background as well. It could be that, you know, your family had some some financial problem, that they were comfortable financially, and then something happened and they lost things, and then they're trying to struggle again and build that up. So you're not new to this. You're used to kind of this kind of pattern around you. It's not a nice pattern, I know, but it's not something that's completely foreign to you. It's not like you're seeing this and really in despair over this. You know that you just have to work your way up again. That's what I'm seeing. And Yes, also you might be trying to prove your worth, prove yourself to someone with all this work you're doing. And this could be this person in the Nine of Pentacles. You might be thinking, oh, this person's really together, they're really well off, they know where they are, they don't have to worry. And look at me, I'm struggling and I'm not good enough. What am I going to do? I have to keep working and try and prove myself to this person. But what I'm seeing is this person's very relaxed. They're not judgmental. They don't judge you. They like you for who you are. So try and relax in this. You know, of course, it's great to be working hard and doing things and achieving things. Of course, that's a fantastic thing. Don't stop doing that, of course. But don't be so stressed about this. Take a little step back from this and think about what's motivating you. Don't try and impress this person, because this person is so relaxed. And I think they do really like you for who they are, for who you are, I should say. They like you for who you are. So, yes, and they're not unapproachable. They're approachable. They're more approachable than you think. So just relax a bit. Just get to know them as a person. Don't think about, oh, the status, I'm this status, they're that status, I have this, they have that. Oh dear, I have to be better than I am. And no, you're you. There's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with them either. They're where they are, they're where you're where you are. So, and they like you for who you are. They like you for who you are. I keep on seeing that. The last card you have here present is the Star. Yes, again, this is following on from the Eight of Pentacles, literally, as well as what I'm seeing here, because the Star I'm seeing can represent all different things, but in this reading I'm seeing, because it's coming after this Eight of Pentacles and coming after this, you know, what, how you feel about this person and trying to make yourself better with this person, if that makes sense. This is about your self-esteem. That's what I'm seeing in the Star. Look at this woman. She looks a little bit vulnerable, more than a little bit, because she's naked. And you're looking at her from afar. You're looking down on her. So she's a little bit vulnerable. She feels like a little bit awkward about this. She doesn't know that you're watching her. But if she put her head up and looked at you, she'd feel really vulnerable. She'd probably go hide behind the tree or run away or something, because she's an innocent woman. That's what I'm seeing. But, you know, you feel a little bit vulnerable. You feel like you don't have as much self-esteem as you would like. That's what I'm seeing. And that's why you feel this way around this person in the Nine of Pentacles. And, you know, you might not be showing this to people. You're not the sort of person who shows this to other people. You're Sagittarius. Of course you don't. But, you know, this is how you could be feeling inside, trying to build this up, trying to build up what you had, trying to improve yourself. You're on the right road, you're on the right track, you're following the Star, so you know where you're going in the right way. But don't be hard on yourself, don't be too hard on yourself. You're a lot harder on yourself than other people are. Just take it easy a bit, relax, get to know this person, they're a nice person, don't worry about it, they're not judging you. And other people aren't either, other people aren't either. The first card you have for your future is the Page of Cups, okay. What I'm seeing here is, I'm laughing because I'm just seeing childishness in this. This is childishness. There's a good side of childishness and there's a bad side of childishness. This is about this person who wants to come back into your life, who's trying to get your attention in the Judgment card. They're trying all sorts of crazy things to try and get your attention. They're still going to be doing this in your future, excuse me. Sorry, I'm coughing again. And they have all sorts of mixed emotions. This person's very, very mixed up. They're very childish in the way that they can laugh, they can cry, they can be funny. But what happens when a child doesn't get their own way? They throw tantrums, they cry, they're in the toy shop saying, I want that toy, I want that toy. I don't care if it costs $2,000. I want it now, that kind of silly tantrum. I want chocolate for breakfast, all sorts of crazy stuff. And they cry and they slam doors. And then the next minute they're laughing and they're being silly and they're running around the room and, you know, doing mad things. That's what this person is like. And that's why you want to get away from them, because they drive you crazy. When you see the good side of them, they're really fun, they're really funny, they laugh about silly things and they have fun. Look at this way, this person's looking at this fish and they're laughing, they're just playing around. But then when things go wrong, it's a disaster. They cannot cope and they're childish. They can't cope with adult life. This is an adult, but they can't cope with adult life. They can't cope with you not wanting to see them. So they're trying to do all these crazy tricks to try and get your attention. But I'm sorry, that just drives you further and further away, because who wants to talk to someone who makes up stories about them, plays crazy tricks on them, tries to ring them and hang up and laugh and then cry and then carry on and do all. You don't want to deal with that. You have enough to deal with. Look how hard you're working. You have enough to deal with. You do not want to deal with this crazy stuff. That's what I'm seeing there. The next card you have for your future is the Ten of Wands. So yes, again, working hard. I'm seeing this all the way through this reading. Working really, really hard. The other thing I'm seeing is that you have this goal that you're trying to get to. You're working your way back to a goal you're trying to achieve. It might be a certain amount of money, might be a certain pay scale, might be something you're working toward, might be a promotion, something like that. You're going towards some sort of financial goal that you have. But what I'm seeing is that you could be, because look at this man, he can't see where he's going. He's carrying too many things. He's carrying too many wands, too many burdens. One burden you do have that I'm seeing in the star is that, excuse me, you're self-conscious. You're worried about how you appear to other people. And that might be what might be blinding you to where you're going. So you might have to drop some of these wands. And some of the wands I'm seeing are, you feel worried about yourself. You're worried about what people think of you. You might have to do things to get this promotion or to get to where you want to go or to take up whatever opportunities come to you. You might want to drop this self-consciousness. You might have to do something in public. You might have to speak in public. You might have to do something on YouTube. You might have to do something where people are going to be listening to you, watching you. I don't know, it might be something like that. It might be something outside of your comfort zone. So you might have to deal with this self-esteem thing. Drop some of these ones. And if you do that, take it slowly, just drop one at a time. Do one little thing that's going to build up your self-esteem just a little bit. Drop another one, maybe do little things that are outside of your comfort zone. Build them up until you've dropped all the ones, and then you can see clearly where you need to go. You'll only be able to see where you need to go when you have dropped this feeling you have about yourself. And there's no need to. Nobody sees you in the way that you see you. Be easy on yourself. That's what I'm seeing. Yes, so the last card you have for your future is the King of Wands. Yes, again. This is the card of action, but to take this kind of action, you need to be flexible. You need to kind of deal with whatever is coming up for you. You need to kind of drop this self-esteem problem, this kind of anxiousness you have around yourself, so that you can get to the next level. If you're going to be getting to the next level, if you're going to be getting to the level of, say, promotion, management, dealing with people, up on stage even, doing things in public, you're going to have to drop the way you feel about yourself, because nobody sees you in that way. Nobody worries about what you look like, what you act. All they're worried about is what is you giving them the information they need. If you can do that, if you can communicate that, then you're fine. You're right. And also, I'm looking at this. The King of Wands is about action. The King of Wands is about being flexible. And the other thing I'm seeing is behind this king, you can see there's a lizard or a salamander behind him. And look what the lizard's doing. It's chasing its tail. It's going around and around and around. Now, unless you drop some of these wands, unless you change the way you feel about yourself, you're going to be chasing your tail. You're going to be working hard, but you're not going to be going in the right direction. You're going to be around and around in circles, chasing your tail. You don't want to chase your tail. You want to be going in the direction that you need to go. That's what I'm seeing. So try and work on how you feel about yourself. That's what I'm seeing there. So Sagittarius, I hope this resonated. As you know, general readings can't always resonate with every single person. But if you like this reading, please like or subscribe or leave a comment if you'd like to. Thank you so, so much for watching.